Good afternoon to all. Children, today we are discussing about the compounds, molecular compounds, and the molecular mass and mole concept from our chapter 9th one, 9th chapter, 6th class. Myself, B. Rajendra, school assistant, physical science, ZPHS, Northern Cal. Molecules, compounds. For example, you have to take water molecule. The water molecule is the combination of hydrogen and oxygen elements by the chemical process and forms the compound. So, the molecule of compounds means a molecule may contain one or more atoms. A molecule may be formed by the combination of atoms of same element or different element. Same element means, for example, hydrogen atom combined and forms that hydrogen gas molecule. Oxygen and oxygen combines and gives that oxygen gas molecule. Oxygen plus oxygen plus oxygen. Three oxygen atoms combined and gives that ozone molecule in this way. Different elements means hydrogen and oxygen combines gives water molecule. Carbon and oxygen combines and gives that carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide in this way. So, molecule of compounds. A molecule may contain one or more atoms. A molecule may be formed by the combination of atoms of same element or different elements. For example, a molecule of water is formed by the combination of two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. All the molecules of water are identical. Chemical formulae of compounds. For these compounds, we can write that formulae, symbol. We already known about the symbol of elements. So that's why for that compound also, we make symbols, formulas. For all the molecules will be identical. It is essential that the atoms of hydrogen and oxygen that are present in molecule must be in fixed number. If this number is not fixed, how could all the particles of water be identical? The water molecule have that constant proportion of the hydrogen atom and oxygen atom. Hydrogen atoms are two and oxygen atom is one. So that's why you can write as the symbol of elements of hydrogen and oxygen, H and O, and the ratios two and one, you can write as H2O1. But no need of writing one mathematically. So that's why you simply write the formula of molecule of water as H2O. Each molecule of water contains two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen, as well as carbon dioxide. Carbon is one, oxygen two. So the symbol of carbon element capital C, the symbol of oxygen capital O, and the ratios are 1:2. No need of writing one as symbol. So CO2. If you want to write C1O2. So CO2. Molecule of carbon dioxide contains one atom of carbon and two atoms of oxygen. Carbon and oxygen also react to form another compound called carbon monoxide. Mono means one atom. Mono ante one. So a molecule of carbon monoxide contains one atom of carbon and one atom of oxygen. So the formula of carbon monoxide compound as CO, C1O1. But as usually we write as CO. Chemical formulae. Can you write the formula of carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide? We already write that CO2 and CO. Try to write formula for them as we have done in case of water molecule. Let us try to write chemical formula of compounds in Kristas method by using valence. The scientists trying to write in different ways. At last, by using the valency, by using the cation plus symbol, anion minus symbol, already we learn about that cation and anion, the charged particles. Every atom having that neutral charge, as well as also molecules also will be in neutral charge. But the combination of the ions in that molecule, they having some valency, and from that valency it will be having cation, means positive charge or negative charge anion. But the charges will be equal, then only the value will be neutral. For example, if I have plus 2, zero kavalante, come to zero means we add minus 2. So for these methods, the scientist Chris explained and gave a method that is known as Chris cross method. Cross means how much of this cation having the charge that is equivalent to the negative charge, the charge of ion. If it is not equivalent, you will be take calcium and equalize the number of ions. We will be see this crisscross method by some examples. For example, sodium carbonate. The following steps should be taken while writing the chemical formula of sodium carbonate. First of all, we write that symbol of sodium. Sodium having the symbol as Na. And carbonate. Carbonate CO3. Na is one ion, CO3 is another ion. Na can lose the one electron, so it is a cation plus one charge. Carbonate having a negative charge, it will be gain or take two electrons, so it is having the negative charge minus 2. For the equivalence of the minus 2, we need plus 2. But the sodium can give only one plus 1. One electron only, that means plus 1. So for equivalent to that minus 2, another sodium ion will be required. So Na ions we will be taking as 2 plus 1 into 2 plus 2, carbonate having the negative sign as minus 2, plus 2 minus 2 is equivalent to 0, means neutral charge. So we write now once again. The sodium valency is Na1 plus 1. CO3 valency is 2. We write that symbols on the top of the symbol of sodium and carbonate. Na1, CO3 taken 2. And divide the valences in the HCF, highest common factor, LCM. So for equivalency, Na need 2. The numbers are there above the symbols. Sodium 1 valency, carbonate 2 valence. For these 2 valencies, we take HCF, that is 2. So with the 2, you product the Na and also as well as CO3. So means divide. So Na2, CO3, 1. If any constituent receives the number 1, ignores if while writing the formula. No need of writing 1. Mathematically, we write simply that without giving the 1. Another numbers 2, 3, 4, you must be write as 2, 3, 4 only. So now the formula of a chemical compound of sodium carbonate is Na2CO3. Na2CO3, Na2CO3. You remember this. Another example, hydrogen chloride, hydrochloride acid. Hydrogen is one, chlorine is another one. Hydrogen valence is one, chlorine valence is one. Chris suggested the method as one and one, right on the top of the element atom symbols, H1Cl1. So this is plus one, that is minus one. Hydrogen cation plus one, chlorine minus ion minus one. Plus one and minus one, if you add, it will be getting that zero, that is neutral charge. No need of HCF. If you take HCF one and one, you can multiply with one and one crossly. H1, one is to Cl2, Cl, Cl1 is to H. So the formula is H1Cl1. But no need of writing one and one. So simply we can write the formula of hydrogen chloride as HCl. HCl. And for magnesium chloride, you can write the magnesium symbol as Mg. Chlorine. Chloride means chlorine. Chlorine symbol as Cl. Magnesium valence is 2. You can write as Mg2 on the top of the symbol of magnesium. Cl, you write as 1. By the method of crisscross, you can cross that 2 and 1 valences. So magnesium 2, for equivalence of magnesium 2, you will be need or required 2 Cl atoms. So that 2 symbol will be goes to chlorine, and require of the magnesium for that equivalency, only one is required. So Cl1 is, you can write as crossly Mg1. So the formula is Mg1Cl2. Mg1Cl2. No need of writing, one means MgCl2. So the formula of magnesium chloride is MgCl2. If you take calcium oxide, calcium symbol is Ca, oxide symbol is O. Calcium. Calcium valence is 2. You write the top of the calcium Ca2, for that oxygen minus 2, means O2. If you take that cation and anion, cation means plus, calcium plus 2, oxygen minus 2. Both are combined the charges, you will be get that 0, plus 2 minus 2 is equivalent 0, means neutral charge. There is no need of HCl, but you take that 2 and 2 HCF as well as coming as 2. So you can write as by the criss-cross method, Ca2O2. That 2 comes to this side, this 2 comes to that side. Ca2O2, both are 2-2 only, so cut it. Then you can write as simply CaO, CaO. For that aluminium sulfate, Al2SO4 taken thrice. An alternate way to writing a correct formula for an ionic compounds is to use the crisscross method. Crisscross method is used for that ionic compounds. In this method, the numerical value of each of the ion charges is crossed over to become the subscript of the other ion. Signs of the charges are dropped. No need of writing charging. Here we are discussing lithium and oxygen. Lithium oxide. Lithium having the symbol valence as plus 1. Oxygen have the valence as 2 minus. By the crisscross method, you can write as 1 and 2 HCF is 2. So lithium's need are required 2, oxygen only 1. So lithium 1 is goes to oxygen, oxygen 2 is comes to lithium. So the formula becomes as lithium 2, oxygen 1, lithium LiO2. And the formula of ionic formula of magnesium sulfide. Magnesium plus 2, S minus 2. So no need of writing the numbers, MgS. sodium carbonate. Na having the plus one valency, carbonate having the minus two valency. So carbonate two comes to this side, Na valency one to come that side. You can write as Na2CO3. This is already we discussing with the words. And here calcium chloride. Element name, charge, element symbol, formula, compound name. This is the total method. First you write calcium. What are the elements are participated in that compound? Calcium and chlorine, write up. And second one, what are the charges and valencies? Calcium can lose two electrons, so we can write as plus two. And chlorine, you can write as minus one. So element symbols are Ca, Cl. By the cross method, HCF is two. So calcium multiply with one, so Ca one. Chlorine two required, so Cl two. So the formula you can write as Ca, Cl2, calcium chloride. Ide means two. In this way, Chris Cross explained his method with a lot of examples. All compounds can write by method of Chris, the great scientist. And from our textbook, some examples are there. Sodium carbonate, already we're discussing about it. So Na2CO3. Sodium bicarbonate, NaHCO3. Sodium hydroxide, NaOH. Copper sulfate, CuSO4. Silver nitrate, AgNO3. Hydrochloric acid, HCl. We already discussed about it. Sulfuric acid, H2SO4. Nitric acid, HNO3. H+1, NO3-1. Ammonium chloride, NH4Cl. NH4+1, Cl-1. Potassium dichromate, K+1, Cr2O7-2. By Kiskas method, it will come as K2Cr2O7. Potassium permanganate, KMnO4. K+1, MnO4⁻¹. K+1, MnO4⁻¹. +1, -1 crossly, you can write as K1, MnO4⁻¹. But you can simply write as KMnO4. By using this method of Chris, you can write this. And after that, the compounds will be readed, the mass, the values, whole we will be discussing in the word of mole. What is that mole? The word mole was introduced by William Ostwald, who derived the term of the Latin word moles, meaning a heap or pile. A mole substance may be considered as a heap of atoms or molecules. The unit of mole was accepted in 1967 to provide a simple way of reporting a large number, the massive heap of atoms and molecules in a sample. Molecular mass. Okay. If formation of a compound, some elements are in that compound. For that atoms having some mass, atomic mass, already we know that. So by using the atomic mass, we can calculate the compound mass also. The compound mass known as molecular mass. So we have already discussed the concept of atomic mass. This concept can be extended to calculate molecular mass. The molecular mass of a substance is the sum of atomic masses of all the atoms present in a molecule of the substance. As atomic mass is a relative, it is therefore the molecular mass is also relative. Atomic mass we have to relative with the 1/12th part of the carbon 12 isotope mass, that is known as one atomic mass unit, AMU. So that is a relative term. So that's why By using that atomic mass, we calculating the molecular mass which atoms are involved in the molecule. So that's why the molecular mass is also relative. Mass of molecule expressed in unified mass as small u. For example, if you take water molecule, the water molecule having two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom, the atomic mass of hydrogen is 1. So 1 into 2 hydrogens, so 1 into 2, 2 atomic masses of plus oxygen atomic mass unit is 16, so plus 16. So totally we get that 2 plus 16 is equal to 18. So the molecular mass of water molecule is 18. We indicated the molecular mass with the symbol of small u. So we can write as the molecular mass of water can write as 18 u. Can discuss with some examples. For molecular elements and for compounds, the formula is needed to determine the molar mass. The molar mass of oxygen, 2 into 2 molar mass of oxygen, 2 into 16. Oxygen molar mass is 16. So 2 times are there. So 2 into 16, 32 grams of per mole is the molar mass of oxygen. Sulfur dioxide. One is sulfur, 2 is oxygen. Sulfur atomic mass is 32. So 1 into 32 plus for oxygen 2 into 16. 32 plus 32 is equal to 64. 64 grams per mole or 64 U are the molar masses of sulfur. For hydrogen, hydrogen, 2 hydrogens are there, 1 oxygen is there. For hydrogen molecular mass is, atomic mass is 1. So 2 into 1, 2 plus 16. 2 plus 16, 18. As well as from our textbook, sulfuric acid, H2SO4. There are 2 hydrogens, 2 into hydrogens, 1 plus sulfur, 32 plus oxygen. 4 oxygen atoms are there. So 4 into 16. So 2, 1, 2 plus 32 plus 64. So you can get as 2 plus 32 plus 64. Totally get as 19 U's. The molecule. As well as most properly popular chemical compound, carbon dioxide. We're reading from 4th and 5th class of carbon dioxide. So the calculating the formula or molar mass of carbon dioxide can write as carbon monoxide as CO2. 1 carbon and 2 oxygens are there. The atomic mass of carbon is 12. So 1 into 12 plus for oxygen, 2 atoms are there. So 2 into 16, 12 plus 32. 12 plus 32 means 44. 44 grams per mole or 44 U. You can write as molar mass of the carbon dioxide as 44 grams per mole or 44 U. In the mole or molar mass of the substance, if you take in that gaseous state at STP, how many number of molecules are there? If you want to count, for example, in your home, there is a rice bag or wheat flour packet. If you want to 1 kg of rice or 1 kg of wheat, 1 kg of sugar, 1 kg of salt, if you want to how many small parts of the how many rice grains are there in 1 kg rice bag? How many wheat flour small particles are there in a 1 kg atta? How many sugar crystals are there in 1 kg sugar packet? How many crystals of salt in their 1 kg packet. If you want to count that particles, you will be count that one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are a lot of number. Large number is there. As well as one molecular mass of any substance, if you take in that state of vapor, means gaseous state at STP, standard temperature and pressure, STP. You remember this word, STP, gaseous state. Then you count that molecules, you will be getting number of large number of molecules are present in the one molar mass. That number is given by the great scientist Avogadro. So the number known as Avogadro number, you denoted with capital N, A. The value will be 6.022 into 10 to the power of 23. In a one mole of the substance, molar mass of the substance, you will be get, after 6, you write 23 zeros and count once, tens, hundred, thousand, then you will be surprised that much of the large number of the molecules are present in the one molar mass of the given substance. Lorenzo Romano Amedeo Carlo Avogadro. Long name. His name also very long. So Avogadro, count of orange and carrot was an Italian scientist, most noted for his contribution to molecular theory, now known as Avogadro's law, which states that equal volume of gas, here you remember that equal volumes of gas under the same conditions of temperature and pressure, that is known as STP, same conditions denoted with capital S, for temperature capital T, for pressure P, STP will contain equal number of molecules. At a standard temperature of pressure, if you have one mole of helium, if you take, it is contains 6.02 into 10 to the power of 23 atoms. And if you forms that vapor or gaseous state of the helium, catch in a balloon, it will be occupies 22.4 liters. One mole of substance is the amount of substance which contains as many particles are entering that are equal to the atoms present in exactly 12 grams of 12 carbon isotope. The number of particles present in a mole of any substance has a fixed the value of 6.022 into 10 to the power of 23. The number is called as Avogadro constant and denoted with Na. It is honored by the Italian scientist of Avogadro. Number of molecules in 18 grams of water as equivalent to 12 grams of carbon, as equivalent to 2 grams of hydrogen, whatever the molar mass, but the molar mass is how much of the molar mass substance, that molar mass of water is equivalently having more atoms in the 12 grams of carbon gases. This number is very large. To handle such large numbers, a unit called as mole. This is a numerical quantity. The Avogadro gives that mole and Avogadro number as 6.02 into 10 to the power of 23. He taken the different gases, helium vapor, oxygen vapor, hydrogen vapor, water vapor, and ammonia vapor. The molecular weights are having different. Helium molar mass is 2. Oxygen molar mass is 32 grams. Water molar mass is 18 grams. Ammonia NH3, N means 14 plus H3, 17 grams. So these are all taking at that same temperature and pressure. If in the water vapor, in that gaseous state, and aqua is 22.4 liters. And if you count that molecules in different molar masses, all are equivalent. That number is 6.02 into 10 to the power of 23. Ikkada molecule mass tho sambandham undu. Molar mass, molecule mass ni maatrame man calculate chesi aa molecule erpadadaniki సహాయపడేటువంటి ఎలిమెంట్స్ యొక్క ఆటమిక్ మాస్ మనం యాడ్ చేసుకొని ఆ డిఫరెంట్ ఆటమిక్ మాసెస్ను బేస్ చేసుకొని మోలార్ మాస్ని మనం ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేస్తాం. ఆ మోలార్ మాస్ని అట్ ఏ స్టాండర్డ్ టెంపరేచర్ అండ్ ప్రెషర్ వద్ద మనము గ్యాసియస్ స్టేట్లోకి మార్చుకొని అందులో ఉండేటువంటి మోల్స్ అంటే అణువుల యొక్క సంఖ్యని లెక్కిస్తే అవన్నీ కూడా ఈక్వలెంట్గా ఉంటాయని చెప్పి ద గ్రేట్ ఇటాలియన్ సైంటిస్ట్ అవగ్రాడో ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్డ్ అబౌట్ ఇట్. అవి అన్నీ కూడా ఆ స్టేజీలో 22.4 liters ఘనపరిమాణాన్ని వాల్యూమ్ను కలిగి ఉంటాయి. సో దట్స్ వై 2 grams ఆఫ్ హీలియం ఈజ్ ఈక్వలెంట్లీ హ్యావింగ్ 32 grams ఆఫ్ ఆక్సిజన్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వలెంట్ టు 18 grams ఆఫ్ వాటర్ వేపర్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వలెంట్ టు 17 grams ఆఫ్ అమోనియా are all having the number of molecules equally as 6.02 into 10 to the power of 23 at a standard temperature and pressure, and also occupies 22.4 liters of the volume at a gaseous state. For this, it gives the statements like this. What is the mole concept? We are discussing statemented like that mole concept. The mole concept is a convenient method of expressing the amount of substance. Any measurement can be broken down into two parts, the numerical magnitude and the units. That the magnitude is expressed in, for example, the ball weight is 2 kilograms. 2 is magnitude number. Kilograms is unit. The mole is the unit of measurement for amount of substance in that international system of units. A mole of a substance or a mole of a particle is defined as containing exactly 6.02214076 into 10 to the power of 23 particles, which may be atoms or molecules or ions or something. So molar mass. Having defined mole, it is easier to know the mass of 1 mole of substance. The mass of 1 mole of substance, which is expressed in grams, is called its molar mass. The molar mass and molecular mass are numerically equally, but molar mass has units grams and molecular mass has unified mass units U only. For example, if you take a molar mass in grams, that is having that number of moles as 6.022 into 10 to the power of 23 particles. At a standard temperature and pressure, it is occupies the volume of 22.4 liters. Every time you will be remember this one. If you give 18 grams of water, means 18 grams of molar mass of water, H2, 2 into 1 plus oxygen, 16, 18. So molar mass of the water molecule is 18 grams. If you take that molar mass of the 18 grams of the water vapor, that is the 1 mole. That is the 1 mole means it is having the volume at standard temperature and pressure in the gaseous state. It occupies 22.4 liters of the volume. If you count that number of moles or atoms or ions in that 18 grams of water vapor, that is having 6.02 into 10 to the power of 23 particles. As well as if you take 44 grams of carbon dioxide, 44 grams of carbon dioxide is the molar mass of the carbon. That is equivalent to 1 mole. 1 mole means it is occupies at STP 22.4 liters in the gaseous state. And it means contains 6.02 into 10 to the power of 23 particles in the 44 grams of carbon dioxide. Means 2 grams of hydrogen, 32 grams of oxygen, 48 grams of ozone, 35.5 of HCl, 36.5 grams of HCl, 18 grams of H2O, 44 grams of CO2, 98 grams of H2SO4, 100 grams of calcium carbonate. These are all having 6.023 × 10²³ particles at a STP in a mole. If you take in that gaseous state, that are all occupies 22.4 liters of the volume. In this way, it gives that mole concept. A mole is a unit of quantity. A mole is having 6.02 × 10²³. Things are particles. This is known as Avogadro's constant, denoted with Na. This is from our textbook. If you take a 1 mole of 2 grams of molecule, given examples here. 2 grams of hydrogen molecule is equivalent to 16 grams of oxygen, is equivalent to the 32 grams of oxygen molecule. This side is atoms, this side is molecule. All are having at STP 6.022 × 10²³ particles only, and occupies in the gaseous state at STP 22.4 liters of volume. So for example, only single hydrogen and oxygen combined and forms that water molecule, then you will be calculated whole. Hydrogen atomic mass unit is 2, 1. So two hydrogen atoms are there in water molecule. So 2 × 1 plus for oxygen atomic mass unit is 16. So 2 + 16 = 18 grams. 18 grams of water vapor contains 6.023 × 10²³ particles. At STP, it is occupies 22.4 liters. In this way, we will be recognize or remember the mole concept. So for only hydrogen gas contains 2 atoms of hydrogen. 1 hydrogen atom molecular weight is 1. So 2 × 1, 2 grams. 2 grams of hydrogen gas having at STP 22.4 liters volume and contains that number of particles in that 1 molar mass of hydrogen, 6.023 × 10²³. Molecules. This is our class today. Mole concept, compounds, and